Open standards are standards that are openly accessible. They can be freely adopted and implemented, and anybody can participate in the further development of these. They are a key component for open source computing, adoption, and growth. As an architect, working with products that use open standards is an extremely smart move. Docker is a fantastic example that can help in understanding open standards and their evolution. For many, Docker is referred to as the de facto container technology, and the term Docker is used extensively elsewhere. There is, for example, the Docker runtime, Docker containers, and Docker desktop. Whilst Docker originally paved the way and exponentially grew the use of container technologies for the better, they have also been instrumental in the creation of open standards and open contributions. In 2015, Docker Inc., CoreOS, and others in the industry collaborated and launched the Open Container Initiative under the control of the Linux Foundation, specifically with a focus of creating open standards for container images, runtimes, and distributions. The format used by Docker when creating images was adopted by the Open Container Initiative. It became the image specification. The image specification outlines how a file system bundle should be packaged into an image. With this standard, there are now a variety of build tools that can be used to create OCI images. For example, there's BuildKit, Podman, and Builder, amongst others. You could use any of these and you'll have an OCI compliant container image. The Open Container Initiative also maintains and manages the runtime specification. The runtime specification outlines how to run a file system bundle, i.e., how to download, how to unpack, and how to run using an OCI compliant runtime. This leads us to the next bit. Docker Inc. also donated its runtime, runC, to the Open Container Initiative as the first open standard, and this is classed as the reference implementation. Now, a variety of runtimes are available, such as Cata Containers, gVisor, and Firecracker. With these examples, we can see the benefits of open standards and how these align to the principles of cloud native. We can openly create our container images as an OCI format using Docker, BuildKit, Podman, Builder, or any other OCI compliant image technologies. Correspondingly, we could run that image created by any of these with technologies that implement the runtime spec. There's also the lesser known distribution specification, which defines a specification on the open standards and API protocols that should be leveraged to standardize the distribution of content. This specification is built on top of the efforts of Docker and was created using the Docker Registry HTTP API version 2 protocol, which is used by Docker Hub. The success of open standards have been influential elsewhere, and there's a variety of open standards that are using Kubernetes amongst other areas. If we take a look at the CNI specification, the Container Network Interface, this is a standard that most people knowingly or unknowingly, depending on their experience, end up using with Kubernetes. I say knowingly or unknowingly, as depending on the approach used for setting up Kubernetes, you may or may not actually see this. A CNI compatible implementation needs to be installed to transition the Kubernetes nodes from not ready to ready. Some of the convenient Kubernetes distributions, like the one embedded with Docker Desktop, will do this for you. Minikube will also do this for you automatically during setup, and optionally you can override the choice of CNI. Others, like KubeADM, require that you choose and install a compatible CNI layer as part of the installation process. Personally, I like CNI as an example of an open standard. Whilst networking in itself is an in-depth, specialized area, the plugin specification is relatively simple, and there are examples out there that will show you how to actually make your own CNI for the likes of Kubernetes, even with simple bash shell scripting. In its simplicity, it is responding accordingly to the CNI command verbs, i.e. add, del, check, and version. There's many CNI implementations available, and again, as these follow open standards, we are able to avoid areas such as vendor lock-in. Okay, so some of the others. The Container Storage Interface, or CSI, an open standard for interfacing with storage solutions. There are a variety of solutions out there that utilize the CSI specifications. There's RUC, which is actually a graduated CNCF project. There are also commercial solutions such as OnDAT and Portworx. Next, we've got the Container Runtime Interface, the CRI. Container Runtime Interfaces are, again, an open standard that is commonly used by the kubelet in Kubernetes, the worker node, to interact with a container runtime engine. The CRI is essentially a plugin interface which enables the kubelet to use a wide variety of container runtimes. So, for example, we could leverage a CRI plugin to communicate with Containerd, CRI-O, Catacontainers, and Firecracker. And then, in turn, these could actually be used by Kubernetes via the kubelet for pod creation. This makes this something which can easily be swapped as required. Whilst I show this as a Kubernetes example, CRI is not exclusive to the kubelet. There are other projects that can also make use of container runtime interfaces, which is the beauty of an open standard. And to finalize on this, we've got the SMI service mesh interfaces. Service meshes are an area that we'll cover in more detail, and there's been a huge growth in service mesh technologies. And as a result, correspondingly, we have a specification for that here. So, after this video, we can now see how important open standards are, and I hope you consider them in your everyday use, especially when selecting solutions for your projects. I'll see you in the next video.